County Kids, City Kids, all the kids that make a difference is supported by Visions Federal Credit Union.
Good evening, and thank you for tuning us in this evening. As I was driving in through the city this evening and getting to the studio, I started to think about all the fall weather, the beautiful crisp air we're getting right now, the leaves falling. This is my favorite time of the year. But I started to watch and listen about all the different things that are happening in school. September and October, I think, was always the greatest time for me as getting ready to get back to relationships with friends and talking to new people that I didn't know maybe before and doing some hobbies and activities that maybe I did for years or just starting. So in a few minutes, we're going to introduce our guests here, and you're going to see that their hobby and their talent probably didn't start in September, but probably a lot sooner than that. But I do want to thank the Vision Federal Credit Union for sponsoring us again this evening, and I'm saying this sincerely. I know they probably don't need to hear this, but I think they should. The BCTV staff is just incredibly awesome. They do a great job, and they're a very small, I think, a close-knit group that works really hard to put shows on, and they do a great job with that. I know how that feels because I'm also from a very small organization and works for them, and we work hard. And I think they do the same thing here at the studio. So thank you to all those that are behind the scenes and getting this show on and all the other shows that they do. And I think they do a great job. So this evening, though, we're going to be talking about a talent that I don't have. My talent of drawing, it's going to be art and drawing. My talent is putting stick figures down and people going, is that a person or what did you draw on there? So as we start this evening, I think you'll find out that these young ladies definitely have a talent. So alongside me this evening, we have four ladies from Governor Mifflin. All right. And we have on the end, I'll let you introduce yourself and the grade that you're in Governor Mifflin. So.
Hi, I'm Morgan. I go to Governor Mifflin, and I'm in 12th grade.
Okay, so you're about ready to spring out of the high school.
Yeah.
And I see a lot of cars that are painted senior. Do you have that?
No, I don't drive yet.
So. That's all right. You don't have to. You'll do that someday. And then next to you.
I'm Cassidy Schultz. I'm a 10th grader at Governor Mifflin.
All right, very nice. And
Hannah Moan, 10th grader at Governor Mifflin.
I'm Sophia Mucky, 10th grade from Governor Mifflin.
All right, and we started this evening as we tried this for 3 months, ladies. I don't know, I guess it was the same ladies, every month it was either a conflict with my schedule or with the studio, and it just didn't work out. But I'm very excited to share some of the things that they're going to share with us this evening. It's art, a simple word. I can spell it, A-R-T, but I definitely do not have a lot of talent in art, and people say, oh yes you do, everybody can draw. I don't agree with that. So we're going to start with some general questions and go from there, and if you feel comfortable and want to share more, go for it, ladies. All right, so I'm going to just put the question out as, how did you start in your art? I'm going to say career, even though you're only in 10th, 11th, and 12th grade. How did you start thinking about art? And we'll start at the end and just work our way up.
Okay, well, as a kindergartner, I had a friend who we drew for each other all the time during our like little play sessions, and she had taken mine home like all the time, and she hung it up to the point where like there were so many that she had to throw some away. But I guess just like the praise and like happiness she got from that kind of inspired me to keep on going and just make art for other people and myself.
Nice. And what kind of art? Like, we'll talk more about this in detail, but what kind of art was it? Just pictures of people or homes, or what did they draw?
Well, at that point, I don't really remember what exactly I drew, but I mean, as far as I can remember back to like middle school era, I did a lot of colored pencil, and right now I'm working with a lot of marker.
Okay, so. And we'll come back to that in a little bit more detail, and let's continue down the line here.
I started drawing more in like 5th and 6th grade, and I didn't really give it to anyone, but my parents always supported me and would tell me that it's really good, and you know, we started doing more art classes at that time, and they were mandatory back in intermediate and middle school, and I just really liked doing that stuff. And now that I'm in the high school, I get to pick those classes and really pick what I want to do.
Good.
I've always loved to draw, but around middle school, when I realized that there was like an art club in high school, I was like really excited.
All right, and Sophia?
It was definitely like, I grew up with a lot of art in my household, and I always knew I wanted to do art. And it really got, when I got to high school and I saw art club was available and so many different art classes were available, that's when I really started to really care about my art and work with it.
Okay, now the next question you're going to sort of laugh about because I don't know art, but what kind of art do you do? So let's start with Sophia. What kind of art, like, is it sketches? Is it watercolor? It's, you know, what?
I stay around using colored pencil for sketches and acrylic paint usually.
Okay, yes. And you don't do color by dots or numbers, right?
No.
You actually start, so how do you do that? How do you start with, okay, let's say this is the canvas and you're sitting there, how do you start that?
You start off with a basic sketch, mm-hmm. and you go off of like what color scheme you wanna do, what colors you wanna do, what colors work together, and then you go from there.
Okay, and Hannah?
I usually just like sketching too. It just basically starts off with like a basic shape and then it just goes from there.
All right.
I do a lot of sketching and like line work, and I use a lot of markers and watercolors probably too. It's just, you know, I do maybe basically, they all said it at the same time.
And I'm trying to remember names. Morgan.
Yeah, okay. Morgan. Well, I usually start with like a set of words to like get my idea of like the project concept usually, and then I go there from like sketching to, you know, the final piece, and then adding my medium. Yeah.
Okay, another question, and I think this is something I always think about. I love reading. I love writing to a point, but I'm not great at writing, but I love doing that. Do you see that art goes with another skill, another talent, another subject? What's your thought on that, any of you?
I mean, yeah, art can go with anything that you want it to go with. Yeah. Like, it can be in science, because you gotta draw, you gotta make things for science, you gotta draw pictures of like botanical stuff and organisms, so that would go around along with science and with history. You gotta draw pictures, you know, if you're trying to figure out what someone some famous person looked like when they're back when they're alive, you can go off of that and all that. And I mean, even math, like architecture and all that stuff goes along with art. You know, everything has art in it if you draw your artist to look at it that way.
Okay. When you're done with a piece, you're looking at it. I always looked at mine and went, ah, I can't stand that. I don't like that. What's your feeling? I want to hear each one of you with a little bit of this and how you go about feeling what your work is, if it's great, bad, if you rip it up, if you take it and start over. So we'll start with Hannah.
Yeah. Okay. Sometimes you just have to deal with it if you don't like it. You can always restart, and, you know, art is all about, like, creation, so you can just do whatever you want.
Are you proud of your work then when you're done? Like, hey, look at this. I have this, and, you know, show it to everybody? Or is it sometimes like, eh?
Well, if I don't really like it, I can always redo it. So at the end, I'm just proud of what I do. So
good.
Okay. Well, sometimes I'm not super proud of my artwork and I don't show it to a lot of people. But there's times where I am proud of my artwork and I try to show it to people. But I'm not usually so keen on showing everyone because I don't want people to feel bad. But I am proud of most of my artworks that I finish. I don't finish a lot of things. Most things are unfinished, but things that I do finish, I'm usually proud of. If I'm doing it and I'm realizing that I'm not liking it, I usually try to restart. But sometimes I just go along with it and try to fix it as I go.
So it relaxes you too?
Yeah.
You get relaxed?
Yeah.
And what's your thought on your paintings?
Well, sometimes there's projects like off the bat, I'm like, I don't know if I'm like mentally all the way in, because sometimes like I might hit a bump in the concept stage, yeah, where I'm not on it off the bat, and then sometimes like, in the end it won't turn out as good as possible. So like, I'll try to fix it as much as like I can, you know, mentally like handle, sort of.
Okay, yeah. Sophia?
It's definitely interesting when like you're at the end of a project and you're like, I personally will show people my art, but inside like I know I don't like it, but I'm still gonna show people to get their opinion for the next piece of art I do. So I can go off of that and what I need to fix the next time I do a new art piece.
Okay. Are you all in art class now in the high school?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yes.
Okay. What sorts of things are you doing in the high school right now as art projects or art activities?
Well, we're working with ink right now, like different like ink and that, like just drawing. We're actually drawing like flowers in that, so it's pretty basic.
And when I ask these questions, I'm not being funny. I'm asking, ink, what do you mean? Isn't there just one kind of ink? Or
I think it's called like a calligrapher or something. I don't know, but it's like the ink pen and like you can put it down. Yeah, but it writes like very nicely. Mm-hmm. It's very good.
So that's, cool. And then that's all in black ink then? Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's black ink. Yeah.
Okay, others?
Well, in my Visual 4 class, we started doing collages a few weeks ago, and we're making this one big project based off of one of our smaller ones that we had done, and it's basically a soul collage, but like layered. I don't know, it sounds kind of weird and, I don't know, hippie-like, but basically just kind of like pick out like things from a magazine, cut it out, whatever like you just feel that you like, and then just kind of just layer it, kind of your personality. So, and it's really fun, yeah.
Okay. Hannah? I'm sorry, Sophia, go ahead.
I'm currently not in a art class at my high school. I go to BCTC, the Career Center, for art advertisement and design technology, and I'm doing a lot of drawing from perspective and shade value using graphite. That's what I'm doing so far.
Is it hard for any of you to catch on to the concepts, like a hair shade? What was the other one, the medium? Is it hard to learn those pieces, or is it easy to you because you love art and you love to draw and sketch?
It depends. Sometimes it's hard to catch on to those things.
All right. Now let's switch gears a little bit, ladies. We're talking about how this show shares and highlights kids of any age and what they do and how they make a difference in their lives, the community, and school. Well, I think in school I've been hearing some of that already, but how about the community? I know that you've shared a little bit with me out in the lobby. Can you tell us a little bit about what's up with the mural? I think, Sophia, you talked about the mural, or someone talked about the mural.
Well, we are all members of like the art club like board executives, so we kind of like get sometimes hit up by different clubs to do different things. And recently we've been contacted by our Key Club, which is a club that like really focuses on like community and school community and stuff like that. And we have like a school garden with like a little scarecrow. It's really cute. But we were contracted to go and make a mural for them. So that's pretty cool.
Nice. And where is this again? The Key Club is going to have it at the school?
Yeah. We have a school garden, yeah.
Very nice. And another one that you're working on, I think?
The mural at, we're doing a mural for Art Club, I believe.
Another one, yeah.
Another one for the Shillington Farmers Market. Yeah.
Good. And where's that going to be located?
We're not quite sure yet. We're running through the plans with everybody at the building and figuring it out.
And I look at a lot of, like all the time I look at different places, murals all over the city, all over different walls. What's the difference between a graffiti that you see versus the art? Is there some way you can answer it?
In my opinion, I think murals are like commissioned, whereas graffitis are just like someone just does
just
it.
Someone
illegally.
Does it.
Yeah. Yeah.
So you're commissioned or you're getting permission to
do something, or someone's getting just doing it on their own without permission to do it. I don't know if that's the actual. Yeah.
I would think so.
Yeah.
So, all right, then let's go back to, I see some pictures here, but before we get to them, I want to talk to you about other things that you do besides art. I'm sure you do a lot of different things, and usually the students I have on this show are very talented in many different ways. So let's start with Sophia, and we'll work this way this time. Tell us some of the things that you're involved with and that you have interest in school and maybe out of school.
I do a lot of church work. I work in my church a lot, and we do a lot of like helping the community as well. So I just love helping the community.
Okay, good.
I'm involved with Key Club, and again, it's like a lot of help with community and work and that, and with food bank and watching like the kids at Brecknock and that. So it's just all around the community.
I also do a lot of church work. We have a church youth group, and we try to do a lot of community work within our church. I'm also a part of the Key Club as a like Hannah, and I'm trying my best to help the community because I like to help people. We do for my youth group at the church. We do the soup kitchen in Reading. I like to do that. You know, I just like to help out the community as best as I can.
I'm a part of our marching band and concert band and our symphonic orchestra. So I do a lot of music work on top of all my other art stuff. But yeah, it's really fun just being a part of like such a big family that like Governor Mifflin has. Yeah. Because then we have our Strike with the Bands coming up soon, which is our marching band competition. So
it's November 2nd.
I think it's November 2nd.
So it's coming up real soon.
And it's at home. November 2nd at 7:30. 7 o'clock.
I'm not actually sure.
I'm not sure the time. You'd have to check out the Governor Mifflin website.
But it's November 2nd, and it's at Governor Mifflin School. Yeah.
And I know that the audience and the ladies here probably don't care about this, but I was the first second Key Club president of Governor Mifflin. And I was also the first chartered member to start Key Club at Governor Mifflin in the 80s. And I was also in Strike with the Bands. We were one of the first years to start that as well in the 80s. So
that's
that was
nice.
Really...
That's cool.
And you see where, you know, it takes you. There's a lot of different avenues that you can go. And I think that's really saying something about how great those activities are. Band, art, music, gymnastics, wrestling, basketball, whatever you have. I think it's talent and it's special. So, all right, then let's go back and let's look at some of the pictures here. And one at a time, I don't care who starts, do a little bit of explanation with it, too. And I guess the camera can get in on most of those. So go ahead, whoever wants to start.
You can go ahead.
I drew my dog. I have a golden retriever. Her name's Penny. This is I think it's expressionism. So if you know, most people probably know who Vincent van Gogh is. His stuff is expressionism. It's not blending your paint strokes, it's just doing paint strokes. And I use my golden retriever is yellow, obviously, and I did the background with blues and purples and greens because that would contrast with the yellow, because this is a hot color and the background would be cool colors. And I just wanted to paint, because last year I drew my other dog, Ozzy, border collie, with graphite, and this year I wanted to draw paint Penny for another project, because I love my dogs and I love dogs and animals in general too. So
really nice. Hot colors versus cool, is it like the bright
like yes yellows, like red, orange, and the yellows are hot colors, and then the blues and purples and greens are cool colors. So
really nice. Really nice.
Thank you.
And are you going to frame that then?
Probably. I don't know.
Did you ever take notice that a lot of the frames cost a lot more than some of the art that you see?
Yeah.
I don't know if it's the wood or what, but it's
a lot.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
And who wants to go next? They all have one. They're all going to show.
Okay, well, this is a marker piece that I did just this year for my AP art class. And it's like a wide variety of like thicker like colored marker and then really fine point like regular black marker. And I just kind of wanted to represent, just because you can't tell from TV, but I'm a very short person, so people tend to call me short. So I just kind of like did it off of that, because sometimes I feel small like a bug. So that's what I based it off of.
So you got stories behind your art. I like that. I think that's really neat. All of you have stories behind your art, I'm sure.
Most of my art,
Okay, and...
So this type of work is called a mandala, and really, like, when you start the mandala, you're supposed to, like, free your mind, and I was just thinking about, like, the future in that. And like what I want to do when I grow up. So it's basically just like a combination of that and just different designs.
Yeah. Really nice. And you said mandala, the coloring books that you get at the stores that where you keep coloring. I love those, but sometimes it's like, okay, I got to stop.
Yeah.
It just drives you crazy. Every little piece, and I'm the type, I have to get every little piece done.
Yeah, in the same
it's
way.
Not going to be white anywhere. It's going to be color. And then Sophia.
This is a piece I did last year in Visual 1. It's called a color field painting. What you do is usually take a wet brush and put a bunch of color on this and then trace what you see. I didn't see many animals, but usually that's what you see. But I really like this type of art piece, and I just love doing these types.
Yeah. Now, each one of you did this, this sort of thing. Do you get things in the art show? I know when I was a kid, we had art shows. They still had the art show going.
Yeah, we still have the art show, yeah.
And how does that go? Like, when do you start it? Who gets selected? How do you...
Well, over the year, every art class, depending on what grade you get, it can be put in the art show, or you can request to put your artwork in the art show if you're in an art class. And at, I think it's in spring, or it's near the end of the school year, they do the art show, and the kids, people that aren't in art classes can go see it. I think the gym classes are mandatory that they have to go see the art show just to, you know, support the art classes. And it's just like, you know, this is a nice way to showcase your art.
Yeah, in AP Art, we have our own wall that we get to display our own sort of gallery, because we have one main theme that we make all of our art throughout the year based around. And we also do like the community ones, so like Yoakum's art show at some point in the year. Yeah, it's pretty nice.
Nice. Anything else? All right, we're running really about 3 minutes here. So what I'm going to do is ask each one of you your goals after high school, because you're old enough that you're not, when I grow up, you're almost there. So let's start with Sophia and we'll work our way down. Tell us your goals after high school, and if it's art or not art or whatever.
I definitely want to be a graphic designer. That's my one goal after high school.
I like really want to do marine biology. I know it's like completely different from art, but I just like always, I always like science and that, so it's, or like paleontology. I just really like things to do with like the history and that, so.
I want to be a forensic scientist when I grow up. When I get out of high school, I want to go into the forensics field because I like science too. And it's not art, but I would rather have art as a hobby than a job, because I feel like I'd hate it if I did it as a job.
Yeah. I haven't decided on a career path just yet, because you know, jumping out of high school is kind of all over the place. But I do want to continue making art, just because it is a very like therapeutic sort of thing to process emotions. So yeah.
Okay. And what's one project that you're working on now, and it can be all of you or just one of you, whatever. What project are you working on now that's going to be in the next, say, couple weeks in art? Is there anything, like, we had talked a lot about the different things you're doing, but is there something that's standing out in the next couple weeks that you're going to start?
I have a continuation piece coming up soon that I have to do for my AP art sort of line of doing work, so I have to sketch that out tonight when I get home.
Uh-oh. We'll be done early so you can get home.
We started it already, but the project that we're working on in art class right now is like taking a piece of music that you like and creating three, not just one piece, any piece or multiple pieces, and creating three like consecutive or art pieces off of it. So I'm excited about that.
Okay.
Yeah. I already talked about the calligraphy earlier, but yeah, it's basically, we do that every Thursday, and the music pieces every other day, so.
Yeah.
Nice.
I'm not quite sure what we're doing in my class, but we've been working a lot about, like, for our project, we keep working up every day and learning more things so our project looks better in the end.
Oh, nice. And within like 30 seconds to a minute, can you share about what you did with the pumpkins and the face painting? Because that's a big hit in Berks County. I don't know if it's anywhere else, but just 30 seconds.
Every year we do the pumpkin painting and face painting for the car crews. And kids love to do it. Like, we have like 50 more kids every year do this. And it's insane to see like what they can create with everything and what they want on their face and how creative they can be with what we're doing.
And I think that's a really neat way to have an older high school student give back to the little ones, because they love it. They think you're really special, which you are, but then they also know that, wow, I got a face painted and look at this face, and they love it. They love to show that. So, well, we're just about out of time here, and I want to thank all four of you for being on tonight, and we finally got there.
Yeah.
And good luck on anything that you do in the next several years, just make sure that you keep a portfolio. I know some people have their actual binder or their portfolios.
Yeah,
like,
portfolio.
So I love that. I think that's really a neat way to do that, to keep that. So if anybody out there is interested in any shows on BCTV with us here with City Kids, County Kids Making a Difference, you can contact the studio and they can give you my name and I can get back to you. But again, it's so nice to see that kids like this are making a difference in their community. And I thank you, and just keep on working the way you are and be proud of what you have. So Anything else?
Thank you for having us. Yeah, thank you for spreading the word.
And then until next month, have a safe month and a good one. Good night. See you next month.
County Kids, City Kids, all the kids that make a difference is supported by Visions Federal Credit Union.